Okay, hi. My name is Theodore Carrington. I'm the third vice president for the New Jersey State Conference of the NAACP. I am second vice president for the New Brunswick branch of the NAACP. Definitely interested in this subject matter, which I will talk about a little bit. I am a member of the Coalition of Black Trade Unionists and a member of the New Jersey Environmental Justice Alliance, which I'm very proud of that membership, as well as my membership with the NAACP. And, you know, here to talk about that proposed coal fire plant in Linden. And I think that background, people need to understand about EJ and how it works, and I think the effect. They want to propose a coal-fired plant in a community that's already overburdened with industry, trucks, highway, energy plants, airport. The community is already overburdened. But, you know, we need to also think about the coal, because we just saw 24 miners. And, you know, for working underground, although these people are mining, they're making a living, but we got to figure out a way to keep them working and get some clean energy. We don't want to be part of that. That'll help continue the mountaintop removal to get coal. We don't want to be a part of that. And so we don't want them to build a new facility and again, in an overburdened community. 50% of the population that will be affected in this particular area, Linden is part of Union County, are people of color. And we don't want to see this happen here. I mean, the idea is to capture the carbon dioxide and run it through a tube 100 miles out to sea and bury it, 70 miles out to sea and bury it, a mile and a half underground, and then with the idea that it'll stay there forever. And, you know, we know better. We know that industry, although we need industry, but very often that their interest is not in our best interest. Their interest is the bottom line is making dollars, and that they don't always look at the health impacts. And that's what we're talking about. We're talking about the cumulative health impacts that the pollution from this plant is going to give. Already in this area, already in New Jersey, asthma, you might even say it's like an epidemic. The youngsters are struggling with their health needs. Youngsters who don't feel well, who are struggling to breathe, don't do well in our schools. And when they don't do well, we have a problem with education. Then you have the parents. The parents may have to take time off from work to come to the school to take care of their children or take their children home. And then you talk about health effects and how if they don't have health insurance and they have to go to the emergency room, this affects us all because it's an extra burden. So it's all a situation where all the dots are connected. We are no longer separated. This is a problem here and not a problem over there. This area affects so many branches of the NAACP, not only Staten Island, which is in another whole state, New York State, but the Roselle branch, the Linden branch, the Irvington branch, the Jersey City branch, the Newark branch, the Perth Amboy branch, the Metuchen Edison branch, the Plainfield branch. All of these areas are going to be affected. This is something that the NAACP, this is an opportunity for us to become a part of a major effort with environmental justice, because it hasn't been a mainstay on our plates in terms of our rights to have clean air, clean water, clean ground to work on. But it's time and for us to use the strength that the NAACP has so that we're no longer discriminated against because of where we live and the color of our skin. This is not right. You do not put more toxic facilities in communities that are already overburdened. You do not add to where we're being overwhelmed by health effects. And you know, the history of these facilities has been devastating. If you really think about it, although a coal-fired plant is not a good idea, but to make it even a slightly good idea would be to put it out in the middle of nowhere, as opposed to right in the heart where people live. And then the discriminatory part is, well, let's put it where people who are less able to rise up and voice their opposition to it. Again, in our community where we're overburdened with crime, with drugs, with housing, with poor education, poor educational systems, here is another a problem that we have to put on our plate. And quite frankly, it hasn't reached the forefront, because the way that environmental issues have been presented, it doesn't look like it affects people of color. But the fact is that environmental justice is that we're being affected more. Global warming, climate change is not something that's going to affect people in the future. It's affecting us right now. And so we have to band with the environmental justice community. We have to get the mainstream environmental community to take another look at what their priorities are, and make sure that they understand that the main priority should be the impact on people, should be the impact on lives of people. I'm very passionate about this, because it's a lot to get black folk to look at a problem that has not been presented to us properly. And it looks like, why should I care about what happens to a polar bear in Antarctica? Well, folks, it's not about that polar bear. It's about global warming. It's about our communities getting heated up much higher than in suburbia. It's talking about the heat island effect, where our temperatures are sky high. You know, 10 or 15 years ago, over 30,000 people died in Europe because of heat. And so all of these things are affecting us now. And one last thing, folks, you have to understand the greatest environmental injustice that you have seen was Katrina, was New Orleans. Over 1,800 people died there. The injustice, what they did with those dikes and dams, they did not build them up. How the government came in and took care of them. How the people are being taken care of right now. So it's important that we take a look at a problem like this, get our community together, get our faith-based leaders, get our civil rights leaders, get all of our leaders together, and ban, and make sure that people understand that this proposed power plant is not going to provide the jobs that they claim it will. It's some of the construction trades, who are not usually friendly to people of color, will get those jobs. And then once the plant is built, it's going to be a few high-tech jobs that most people won't even qualify for. We have to look at the whole picture, not just part of it. And once we make this clear and plain to people to see, we should be able to rise up, show our indignation that they are insisting upon putting another burden in our community. And I think that we can stop this proposed power plant. I am glad to know that you are interested in this subject matter. I'm glad to know that you're watching this. You should reach out to your NAACP. You should try to make sure that there's an environmental justice committee that's in your NAACP branch, one that should form in your community, because we have to pay attention, because others are not going to give us this information. Others are not going to tell us. Others are going to paint it over with a glossy photo. Well, folks, you have to pay attention, because crime And a lot of it has to do with the injustice that we serve with the environment. Thank you.